Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day. Ira Epstein of Linen Associates with your financial market wrap-up for this Tuesday. And we are now at the 19th of December, 2017, just around 4.05 p.m. Central Standard Time. So the House of Representatives passes the tax bill, goes to the Senate. They're already debating it. Now there's a parliamentary procedure that regardless of what happens in the Senate, it'll probably get passed as it is. It goes back to the House for the House to approve whatever the Senate amendment comes in, as long as not a material change, just a parliamentary change. It is so confusing. However, I think that all this means is the race is on to get all this done. We'll probably hear about 10 o'clock tonight. That's my guess. And I'm talking Central Time, that it passes the Senate in some measure. Then the House will take up the vote in the morning. If they pass it, I would not be surprised to see a signing ceremony as early as tomorrow afternoon with the president. The interesting part is you did not go up in the stock market on the good news. That I thought was interesting. The dollar fell on the news, another interesting point. Bitcoin got really nothing today in the way of news on it, yet it went from as high as around 19,500 to 17,200, and because it wasn't an update for it, it didn't get any press on it. Fascinating. You're still up on the crude, and that in part has to do with the Forties pipeline, that is where 450,000 barrels a day come from the North Sea to the UK. There was a leak on land. The parts were ordered, and I understand now as an update, they've been delivered. They're still saying anywhere from another week to 2 weeks. In other words, around the first of the year that this will get up and running. You got to wait and see. They originally said could be 3 to 4 weeks from December 11th. Take away that time, you see where you're at. But on the S&P, let's not fight what's going on. Overall, you're still up 30 points for the week. Congratulations. As you take a look at the S&P 500 on the daily area chart of closes, we come up and we slipped back today, and you're down 10 points. Okay, you didn't break anything on the charts, and you can see the action here. The market's consolidating, you might say. And remember, what date are we? We're at the 19th. Friday, in some markets, we have abbreviated trading for the Christmas weekend. Then you've got Sunday night trading that you open, Monday trading, and I'm talking electronic type sessions, and I've sent this all out to our clients and so on. And then Tuesday night, we get back to normal until the beginning of the year, right? New Year's Eve. So it starts getting broken up from this point forward. I'm noticing taking transportation to the office how much lighter the transportation is. I take public transportation in the city. If you live in Chicago, it's like New York or other places. It costs you $25 a day to park a car. You don't need to do that. So you learn to take your public transportation. Yesterday, I was the only person on a bus at 7 in the morning. That was strange as can be. Normally, it's jammed like that. But as you look at it, still a bull trend, higher highs, higher lows. The market is over the 18-day moving average of closes. And as I mentioned yesterday, I've been looking for this average to get higher than the last break low. I didn't know if it would be today or not. Well, it's probably tomorrow. So on a pullback, this low area is probably going to be important of 26.51. You can see that the Bollinger Bands have stopped the rally again. They've really done a good job of offering a theoretical resistance so traders can guess an area where some resistance might come in. And the momentum of the market's still locked in and bullish. You have not lost that embedded reading. I see this as still a bull trend. In the NASDAQ, you are overbought. But how many days do we have with both numbers now over 80? Today it did it. Yesterday it did it. The day before it did not. Therefore, as I'm looking at all this, you need to have one more day to have the embedded reading. The fact that the market pulled back today is good. It makes that easy for the market if you don't get a big break tomorrow. We'll see what happens. But here's all I care. Take the name of the chart off. Take off that it's a stock index. You're trading sideways in Bollinger Bands. You're trying to push out the upper top. If it fails, you pull back here. But this whole area becomes the launching pad either for a move to the upside or break through these lows and something more of a correction. I was on Fox Business today, and they were trying to pull out of me. The market's going to break. What would you do it with it? You know, Liz Claman was talking, and Liz is a great host. And the question was, what would you do on an 8% break? And my answer was, you buy. Why? Number one, we haven't had one in a while. Number two, why would I buy? That was the question to me. I'm not telling you to buy here. I'm discussing it with you. And I said, America's firing on all cylinders. Europe's firing on all cylinders. And today, China decided that they've done enough on pulling back on the credit. They don't want to slow their growth too much. They'd rather take a small gamble or a gamble. I don't know which way they're going to call it, and let credit flow a bit freer. Well, if they do that, that's going to create some growth to the economy. That's their thought. Well, you put all that together, it's hard to be bearish. That doesn't mean tomorrow you won't break 20%, and I'm totally wrong. Got that. I'm just giving what I was asked and how I responded. And here you have an embedded reading. So I see higher lows, higher highs, the trend's still up. In the Russell, this has been, like the NASDAQ, those are the two markets that have had the harder time. This market has traveled trying to get to the lower band that it didn't hit. It did get back to the upper band. It wouldn't surprise me if it just tries to play around at this 18-day average if it follows through to the downside a little bit. But I'm seeing again here, and you start looking for that. Are we getting that sideways action? From sideways action, moves develop. They can be up or down, but that is generally the prelude to a move. In the VIX, back up, challenging the 18-day average of closes, so we're getting a little bit of a bounce now. The market is in oversold territory. Wouldn't be surprised to see levels of resistance from 1031 to 1073. Could you get a big pop to the upside if all of a sudden this tax bill didn't go through? You can count on it. Will the tax bill go through? I wish I could say I know the future. I'd be willing to bet pretty big it's going to be done tomorrow, but these procedural things, they have a way of shaking things up. On TLT, this didn't surprise me. Remember we were talking and I said, it's so strange. We're getting this tax bill and real rates are falling. Well, now you got the two-day reversal. This market went to the upper Bollinger band. 48 hours later, it's at the lower band. Now I'm not surprised. Same in the T-bond market. And remember, this is an inversion market. The higher futures are going, the lower real rates are going. With the tax bill passage today, bang, this market just came unglued. You came down hard in the 10-year note. All of them came down hard, as this is bullish for the economy. And if it's bullish, money coming back maybe into the U.S., will there be job creation? We don't know, but there'll certainly be money brought back to corporations. Will they pass that around? Will some of that go to job creation, create inflationary pressures? Not exactly sure how it all works, but the futures market reacted down. The dollar is interesting. You got now lower highs, lower lows. It closed literally under the 18-day average of closes. In theory, it threw out a bear signal now. Momentum is down. If this market follows through, you could be headed to 92.32 on this. You threw out the opposite signal in the euro. You threw out a bullish signal. Higher lows now, higher highs, and you closed over both those numbers. So right now, we saw a flip-flop in trends in these two markets. The Aussie dollar, higher lows, higher highs, overbought in a resistance area of the upper Bollinger Band. And by the way, should it decide to get back to the 18-day average, it would actually throw out a sell signal. You'd have lower highs, lower lows. So the bulls probably want to defend the 76.89 level. In the Japanese yen, bear signals, lower highs, lower lows, momentum flat, didn't turn quite yet, the bias is down. You'd have to take out 89.77 to negate the bearishness in that market. Bitcoin, as you can see, got under its lower Bollinger band on the 15-minute charts. I don't have enough data yet on futures, and it'll be a while before we have 60 days of data or so. So I'll stay with this, but the momentum of the market, you can see earlier this morning, you were at 19,500. This is a 15-minute chart. You just went to 17,250. No news on it at all on the financial wires. In the crude oil, as long as the 40s pipeline stays in problems, in other words, it's not producing, it's going to give the Brent something of a bid. Now, when they see that there's light at the end of the tunnel, that probably changes. But it's buy the rumor, sell the fact. While the parts are supposedly on land in the UK to now fix the broken parts of the pipeline, until it's up and running, you don't have oil flow. So you can see the Brent. You've got the higher lows, higher highs, still bullish momentum, slightly higher. The bias is up. Resistance, the upper Bollinger Band. WTI crude, well, we don't have the same problems they have. So we have a lot of shale production yet. So you've got lower highs, but you don't have lower lows. You got higher lows and lower highs. The market is just sort of hugging here, waiting for some development there. In the Rebob gas, up until this, that you had lower highs, lower lows. With today's action, I'll take this arrow away, and now I'll have higher lows, higher highs. What else do you see? Oversold, momentum turning up, resistance 171.08, 18-day average, but the market's trying to turn up right here. Nat gas tried to lift its head today, didn't do a very good job. It's knocking on the door of losing the embedded reading, but hasn't lost it. The pros are still selling this market at this point in time from everything I can see with that. I want to remind you what we've got. Remember, it's Christmas time. I'm trying to give everybody something. My charting course. My charting course normally runs $109.95. It's all online. Typically, it comes with the charting materials, in other words, the charting software itself, access to 6 hours of videos. Boy, I know it wasn't 60. 6 hours of my videos. And of course, my daily market research, assuming you haven't had that yet. For Christmas, with the words XMAS, no apostrophe, just put it on the coupon, $79.95. Now, the charting software alone, when you get it from us, is $99.95 a month. My research is $60. So for $150 just in that, you get also the course, and I discount everything for $79.95. You're going to learn five different tools, five techniques that I use of indicators, window envelopes, slow stochastics, the swing lines, moving averages, and forgot which one I didn't say, but there's five altogether. And you put them together, and then I reinforce it for you every morning that I'm here with a live update, which brings me to tomorrow. I'm not going to be doing my live morning update. I have an eye doctor exam, and I couldn't get in any other time by Christmas, and I have to go. Something's bothering me there. So I'm just not going to be here early morning. I'll be here right after that. Again, everything's online, how you buy it. Go to our website, www.irapstein.com, under education. Everything you need is there. You can also click up here if you're watching me on YouTube. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I'll see you all tomorrow.